Few things are as terrifying as black holes. They gobble up everything, including massive stars, dust, errant spaceships, etc. Their appetite is so insatiable that they also swallow light. However, the opposite of black holes exists, and they are no less terrifying. These massive objects are called white holes, and their discovery sets off excitement in the astronomy community. How are white holes formed, and what makes them so unique? Well, stick around to the end of the video to find out. Even though you might be intrigued, you don't really want to get too close to a black hole, because you will end up inside its dark belly. The most common black holes, the stellar black holes, are formed when the center of a very massive star collapses in upon itself. This collapse also causes a supernova, or an exploding star, that blasts part of the star into space. Scientists believe supermassive black holes form simultaneously as the galaxy they are in, meaning most galaxies, including our dear Milky Way, have a black hole at their core. The size of the supermassive black hole is related to the size and mass of the galaxy it is in. The black hole at the center of our galaxy is known as the Sagittarius A, and can swallow up to 4 million of our suns with room to spare. We could have ended up in its belly, but we were far enough away to be safe. The strong gravity the black holes exert on objects near them is due to an enormous amount of matter having been pressed into a tiny space. This compression can take place at the end of a star's life. Yes, exploding stars are actually dying stars, and no, the sun will never become a black hole simply because it's not big enough. It will only become a red giant star, after which it will transform into a glowing ring of gas called a planetary nebula. Finally, all that will be left of the sun is a cooling white dwarf star. You can't see a black hole the way you see a star. The scientists detect them from their effect on their surroundings. The first way we detect black holes is by their gravitational influence. For example, at the center of the Milky Way, we see an empty spot where all the stars circle as if they were orbiting a really dense mass. That's where the black hole is. The second way is by observing the matter falling into the black hole. As matter falls in, it settles in a disk around the black hole that can get very hot. Some of the energy liberated from falling in is turned into light, which we can then see, for example, in X-rays. Now imagine you can reverse a black hole. Deep space is a scary place, where lots of things are going on at the same time. So while black holes grab at everything, their counterpart white holes do the opposite. A theoretical white hole is the exact opposite of a black hole. As stated before, once material has reached the event horizon in a black hole, nothing can escape its strong gravitational pull. Similarly, a white hole is a region in which space-time flows inexorably outwards. It is theorized to have an event horizon radius, which prohibits the entry of any matter, including light. For this reason, white holes are believed to expel light, radiating at levels that are equal to the force of a black hole. The theory of white holes was derived from the mathematical fascination of black holes. In 1905, Albert Einstein discovered that, although accelerating observers experience time differently, that does not apply to non-accelerating observers when moving at a constant speed or stationary. He also discovered the universal truth that the speed of light was independent of all motion. Einstein then published his theory of general relativity, which tells us that objects with mass have gravity, and this gravity is a distortion of time and space, instead of being an actual physical force. Karl Schwarzschild took Einstein's field equations further and used them to solve the equation of mass in empty space-time, or an area completely void of all matter. This resulted in the Schwarzschild metric. The equation itself is in fact very complex, but it's simply a mathematical representation of a black hole. However, the black hole in Schwarzschild's equation is the type without charge or change and is known as an eternal black hole. That is, a black hole that does not change in size and has always existed. Beyond the event horizon, all events happen infinitely far in the future, and so, to an outside observer, these events never happen. The Schwarzschild metric shows us that at the idealized black hole, space becomes time and time becomes space, swapping their roles so that the singularity of the black hole is in some inevitable future time instead of a place. Now try to reverse time in a real black hole and you will see a dying star. However, when reversing an eternal black hole, we get a white hole. Where do white holes come from? There are several theories, but researchers suggested that black holes and white holes are connected with matter and energy falling into a black hole, potentially emerging from a white hole, either somewhere else in the cosmos or another universe entirely. Carlo Rovelli in France and his colleagues suggested the black holes and white holes might be connected in another way. When black holes die, they could become white holes. In the 1970s, physicist Stephen Hawking calculated that all black holes should evaporate mass by emitting radiation. Black holes that lose more mass than they gain are expected to shrink and ultimately vanish. However, Rovelli and his colleagues suggested that shrinking black holes could not disappear if the fabric of space and time were quantum. That is made of indivisible quantities known as quanta. Space-time is quantum in research that seeks to unite general relativity, which can explain the nature of gravity, with quantum mechanics, which can describe the behavior of all the known particles into a single theory that can explain all the forces of the universe. In the 2014 study, Rovelli and his team suggested that once a black hole evaporated to a degree where it could not shrink any further because space-time could not be squeezed into anything smaller, the dying black hole would then rebound to form a white hole. However, the process of a black hole turning into a white hole is suggested by Rovelli and his colleagues is not a fast one. Rovelli estimated that a black hole with a mass equal to that of the Sun would take about a quadrillion times the current age of the universe to convert into a white hole. Besides, this theory means white holes cannot be created directly, unlike black holes that result from dying stars. Other theories put the formation of white holes just a second after the Big Bang due to random density fluctuations in the hot, rapidly expanding newborn universe. According to this school of thought, areas where these fluctuations concentrated matter together could have collapsed to form black holes. These primordial black holes would be much smaller than stellar mass black holes and could have died to create white holes within the lifetime of the universe. For now, white holes are only theoretical, but that is not enough reason to knock the science behind their discovery. At any rate, black holes started as an idea as well, and they have not only since been proven to exist, but have been found to exist all over our observable universe. One of the biggest mysteries lies in the phenomenon of the expansion of the universe. We know for sure that the universe is expanding, but we aren't sure what is causing it. But similarly to other invisible things in existence and science, we think it is caused by dark energy. The expansion of the universe is, in a sense, the effect on other natural phenomena we can observe that lends credence to the existence of this mysterious and invisible force we call dark energy. Could white holes have something to do with this expanding mystery? Could they be the catalyst behind dark energy? Could it be that while black holes of the force is trying to bring this universe together, white holes are actively working against those aims by pushing the universe apart? Or is the answer to this cosmic mathematical riddle something even more outrageous? Because as is often the case, the truth is stranger than fiction. While some scientists contend that white holes are not real, the idea could solve a number of problems plaguing physics. First to be resolved is the black hole information paradox. Put simply, the paradox states that the information entering black holes would disappear entirely along with the death of a black hole as it evaporated into nothing. But information can never be completely destroyed. Quantum bounces would solve that problem neatly. All the information stored within a black hole would simply be spewed out when it becomes a white hole. Does that mean there is theoretically hope for anybody that falls inside a black hole? Well, one thing is for sure, we do not recommend that you try to verify this theory. White holes might also help explain the identity of dark matter, another tough concept for theorists to resolve. Logically, something has to be holding together parts of the universe, even though nothing is visibly doing so. The current explanation calls that invisible stuff dark matter, a mysterious substance that doesn't react with light or any other known force of nature except gravity. Fascinatingly, white holes may just be what we have always known as the Big Bang. Sound crazy? Well, hear us out. The mathematics is largely similar for talking about a white hole's emissions and the Big Bang's creations. Both events are fundamentally mysterious, and it is difficult to even think about what happened before the Big Bang and what caused it, but the same applies to white holes. Bear in mind that Einstein's equations only described how white holes can exist, but not how they originated. White holes have fundamentally enigmatic origins, and if we were to ever come into proximity with them, they would probably blow our minds.